Hi there. Today I want to ask you, what do you look for in people when you're interviewing them? Or whom do you get impressed by? The guys who give you stories or people who are real in nature, who actually tell you things as they are. It's quite likely that you like the former like me. People who come for interviews and tell us success stories, talk about how they conquered the world, how they wrote magical software code which saved the company. These are the people that we're likely to be impressed by. The people who come and say, look, I'm going through a bad phase. This is not so good time for the company and me. Hence, I'm looking for a job. Though I've done a great job in the past, these are not the kind of people we are likely to be impressed by. I'm sure some of us may hire them, but most likely we'd like to hear a positive spin in the story, even if it's a screw up. I can relate to it very well. You know, in the past when I used to work for a startup once, you know, we were struggling in a phase where salaries were not being paid. And it was a low phase in my personal life. I was a sole breadwinner for the family. And in desperation, I went and attended an interview with a Fortune 500 medical equipment firm. I thought the interview went okay, but thereon, I got a feedback from the headhunter saying they didn't like my energy levels. Yes, they said the energy levels were pretty low. I could relate to it later on saying, yeah, maybe, you know, it was not so good phase in life, so my energy was low. But that thing called energy still rings in my life, you know, ears. And over a period of time, whenever I attended interviews, I sort of ensure that I acted well to get the energy out. So, what are the key things that actually impress us in an interview? The looks, the dressing, the voice, the smile, the composure. Many of us say energy. Energy is something very infectious. We come out and say, bande mein kya energy hai? Or we say the other way around, bande mein energy nahi hai yaar. You know, as though, you know, we are in a power company which needs to generate electricity and we need a lot of energy from people, right? So, what is this thing about, you know, listening to people who are energetic, who bring positive stories, who actually say that everything is great for them? All the people who are successful, doing well for themselves in life, and most importantly in their job, are likely to continue in their own company. Very few of them will be attending interviews because they'll be making their increments, they'll be making their bonuses, maybe even overseas trips. You know, their bosses will be taking care of them. Recognition wise, they'll be on their high. So they wouldn't be the guys most likely to attend interviews. So it is quite likely that people who are not so in their high phase would be meeting us for interviews. So why can't we take the stories about it's not the best phase for them in life, they have potential, that's the reason we recruit them. But that's not how recruitment always works, does it? Now, when we interview people, we expect to hear the spin of the positive side. So that is something we take to their joining dates and tell their team, look, you know, so and so has joined and he or she actually has done the following things so well that, you know, they are the right people whom we wanted to hire. So interviews are about bravado. They are not the place where somebody comes and says, I screwed up, so please hire me. If you ask me, I think I've hired a lot of people who are, you know, successful. That was always the kind of mantra that I told myself. Only later I realized that few of them had possibly failed in the previous assignment. They were desperate and I hired them. But that was, you know, in the past. And I think even today, so that's a kind of a bias. Even for me, I look for people who have energy. Not too much of people who come and say I failed. Maybe that's how I've ingrained. I'm changing, but I think more often this is a struggle all of us go through, isn't it? It is very difficult to accept somebody has failed and still hire them. That's not the narrative we want to hear. We think the guy is, you know, low, the guy has negative attitude, and that is a very difficult thing to digest, isn't it? So today I want to leave you with this thought. If at all you're hiring people, what do you look for? Will you accept somebody who said, I failed, still hire me? I know we'll all say yes, but ask yourself honestly, is that what you want to hear in an interview? You want to hear somebody who says, I screwed up, but I still can do a great job. So tell me what you think today about whom you want to hire while interviewing people. What do you look for? Thank you for listening and watching today.